Hey y'all, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today is Wednesday, June 12th, and today I am going to be filming a keto full day of eating vlog. Today marks day 8 of my vacation slim down, and as of this morning, I am down a little bit more weight, but I'm sitting 0.2 pounds above my lowest weight. So my lowest weight that I weighed in at for one day last year was 154.6. Today I was 154.8. Very, very, very close to having a new low weight, and I'm so excited about that. But this morning I have a couple of things to do, and then in about 30 minutes I am headed out the door and going to go get my CrossFit workout on. It is definitely going to be a bit of a tough workout today, but it should be a good time anyways. I think after that we may go out on the boat this afternoon, do some fishing, and it should be a fun day. So let's go ahead and get this day started. Let's go. So I just had a non-scale victory, and I wanted to share it with y'all because I'm super stoked right now. So a couple weeks ago, I got an order in the mail. It was like some boots and some Western clothes, and I showed it to y'all, and I said that the shorts I bought did not fit. Well, this morning I was like, you know what? I'm gonna give those a try. I wonder if anything has changed. Like, I could barely get these like over my hips. I was nowhere near buttoning them. And guess what, guys? They buttoned. They buttoned, and they're not like uncomfortably tight. I don't know if they flatter me very well, but you know what? I don't care right now. I just know that they buttoned and they fit. And I wish these were cuter on. They look cute in the back, but this front, I don't know if I like it or not, but I just had to share with y'all, they fit. That's so exciting! Now I've got to see if I can make them look cute. I don't know, but they fit. So, just had to share that with y'all because I'm just excited right now. Well, I am glad I was able to get a little bit of footage for y'all while I was at CrossFit today. That workout was definitely pretty brutal. It kicked my butt, but I'm so glad I went and did it. I finished it, and that is all that matters. So the warm-up today was 10 minutes of handstands. So we would work for 30 seconds and then have a 30-second rest, and that continued for 10 minutes. And then we went on to the Metcon today, or the workout. And that was a 250 meter row, 12 thrusters, and 12 ring rows for a total of 4 rounds. It took me about 17 and a half minutes to finish all 4 rounds, but the shoulder work we've been doing the past couple of days combined with the handstand work we did at the beginning of the workout, my shoulders are beat. Oh my golly, they hurt. We've done so much shoulder work lately, but like my traps and stuff are looking more defined, so I guess that's a good thing. But Yeah, I'm taking tomorrow off. It's gonna be a much needed rest day. But Cody just called me and he said he's ready to go out on the boat. So I guess I'm going home and getting ready to go fishing. So yeah, got my workout in and now it's time to catch us some dinner. Maybe, let's hope so. It is currently 1:07 and Cody and I are fixing to head out to go fishing, but I wanted to eat my first meal of the day, and that basically consists of all the leftovers in the fridge that we have. So I have half an Italian sausage link, I have 6 meatballs from our spaghetti last night, some macadamia nuts, and this super fat macadamia nut and almond butter blend. It's got 4 net carbs, 21 grams of fat, just a good chunk of fat to keep me feeling full for a while. All right, going to scarf this down and it's time to go fishing. All right, guys, it is 2:07. I'm joined here with Cody.
Hey.
And Bo, and we got the boat towing behind us and we're headed to go fishing. One of Cody's friends is gonna meet us at the boat ramp and we're all three gonna go out, do some fishing. I'm actually very thankful that it's an overcast day, so the sun isn't gonna be beaming down on us. It's 88 degrees outside. We can put up our bimini top, give us some shade. It should be a good afternoon of fishing. Well, I will check in with y'all when we're on the boat. We're about to go get us some live bait and go hit the water. Look at how big these shrimp are that we are using for bait today. These things are huge, literally as big as my hand. Look at that. If that doesn't catch us a big fish, I don't know what will. Bo's falling off the boat. Oh my god. Look at that sheep's head. Look at this fish.
Did you gut it?
No. See the hook right there.
We are out here doing a little bit of fishing. We're out in the middle of Mobile Bay on a fishing reef. It's a definitely a bit rough. We've caught a couple fish and we're gonna keep on fishing. Bo really wants to go overboard today, so he has to wear his life vest. So, making sure he's safe. But yeah, hopefully we catch some big fish. Cody's coming in with the weirdest catch of the day. A stingray. Yeah, he's gonna be fun to get off. I caught myself a little speckled trout, a couple inches short of being legal. Bo really wants to eat him, but I am going to let him go live another day. Grow to be legal size.
I think these are the tails that slap you, aren't they?
Yeah. Cody is just reeling in the stingrays today. The second one.
Machine, y'all.
Just caught a little mangrove snapper. These are really, really good for fish tacos. But I don't think he's legal size anyway, so there he goes. Look at this big old ship going by. Heading out. Wow, Cody's hooked up to the third stingray of the day. Look at them, they're so cool, but not what you want on your boat, that's for sure. Cody just pulled in this massive flounder. Holy moly. Ah! Ah!
hook out. Hooks in him. Oh well, I'm done anyways. I'll end the day on that.
Look at how big this thing is compared to my foot. Oh my gosh. Wow. We are off the boat. It is currently 7:20. We had an awesome time out on the water, and I hooked into the biggest fish of my life out there. It was just pulling my drag out, and I was using every bit of strength I had to like lift up the rod and reel it in, and the line broke as soon as it got to the boat. We didn't see what kind of fish it was, but I was fighting that thing, and I'm so upset that I didn't get to land that fish. It was big, whatever it was. And then we just caught some like trash fish, like some gross catfish. Cody caught 3 stingrays today.
Stingray honey hole. Y'all wanna go on a charter trip for stingrays? I got you.
We can take you fishing for stingrays. But then Cody caught a huge flounder. Huge. Absolutely huge. He was so excited.
Right under 7 pounds, y'all.
Yeah. That is a massive
fish. She will insert the picture now.
I will definitely insert pictures of his fish. But yeah, flounder is apparently really, really good to eat. I don't know if I've ever had flounder. So we brought that flounder home with us. We're about to go fillet it and probably freeze it to eat either later this week or maybe next week or something.
Friday.
But yeah, so fishing trip was successful. Had a great time. Still got the boat behind us. Gonna go fillet the fish at Cody's parents' house and then go put the boat up. And then I have no idea what we're doing for dinner. So there's that. But yeah, just had to give y'all an update. Was a grand old time. It was a good day. Good day. Just look at that pretty little setup we got going on right there. Truck and boat. Oh, they just look so good. We've got old Captain Cody doing a little clean down of the boat. All right, here is Cody's big old flounder, and it is time to fillet him for dinner later this week. Look at their two eyes. It's so cool.
When it all looks like that, you got it right.
I guess?
Yep.
So Cody just pulled the scales off of both sides of this flounder, and now pretty much all we do is cut off the head, remove the guts, and when we cook it in a couple of days, you cook it whole like this.
Eat skin and all, y'all. That's sharp, honey.
Head is cut off, guts are removed, and this fish is ready to be cooked in a couple of days. Hey guys, we are finally back home after like 8.5 hours of fishing and cleaning fish and doing all of that boat and fishing related stuff. But we are finally home and it is like 10:30 at night and your girl is flat out pooped. I'm so tired. I don't even want to eat. I just want to go lay down in bed and go to sleep. But I know I need to eat something else before I go to bed tonight. So I am going to see what I can scrounge up to eat because I am so tired. I want nothing to do with cooking. I need someone that just like cooks my meals and has them waiting for me. How do I get rich enough to have a personal chef? I don't know. All right. So, yeah, I'm gonna go figure out what to eat. Update. I am so excited. I went and looked in the fridge and I forgot that I had some leftover pork tenderloin and vegetables from a couple of days ago. And I think it's still good, it still smells good, so I'm gonna eat it. And yeah, so let me show you what it is. I'm about to dig in, and that's gonna be my meal of the night because I don't have to do any work. Yay! I can just go shower and go to bed after I eat this because your girl smells like a fish and is greasy like a son of a gun. Woo! Ooh. My second meal of the day is really nothing special, just leftovers once again. But I think after this, I've pretty much eaten every bit of leftovers we've had in the past couple of days, which is great because I hate wasting food. Well, this is a piece of pork tenderloin, and this is some squash and sauteed onions. So I am just gonna go pick at this, eat some food, and make me feel nice and fat and happy. Well, it is now the next morning. So after I ate my meal last night, I told Cody, if I go sit on the couch right now, I am going to pass out. Well, I went and sat on the couch and I passed out. And at 2 a.m., I woke up and looked at my phone. I was like, oh my gosh, it is 2 in the morning. I fell asleep on the couch, so did Cody, for like 4 hours. We were obviously exhausted, needed some rest. So yeah, that is what was going on. I hope that you guys enjoyed this vlog. I thought it was super fun. We caught some fun fish, showed you how we cleaned that flounder. And tomorrow, we are actually going to be cooking him for dinner because my mom is coming into town, so it should be absolutely delicious. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a big thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel down below if you haven't done so. And I will see y'all again real soon with another video. Bye, guys. Mwah!